for sight since taking office. Severe winter weather across the South over Valentine's Day weekend battered multiple states. Texas bore the brunt of unseasonably frigid conditions. It caused widespread power outages, burst pipes, and flooded homes. Millions of residents lost heat and running water. I'm Ron Otto, 1290 and 95.7 WHIO.
Now let's take a look at the latest numbers from Wall Street this noon hour. Stocks are down 179 points, not good. 31,222 currently. And at last check, the price of crude oil is down $1.14 to $62.39 a barrel.
Stocks may not be good, but our weather sure is. Oh, it's treating us nicely so far. Letitia mentioned that 50-degree day and on Wednesday just kind of threw her off a little bit because it's a little cooler here Thursday and Friday. But we're still right around or slightly above where we should be for this time of year. And then we've got some more fool's gold coming over the weekend, too, where we get even warmer. And then we'll cool back down a little bit into next week. But again, next week, we're still going to be at or slightly above average for this time of year. I just think we really start to appreciate that. You know, the memes on Facebook where, you know, you talk about it's 30s and 40s in Ohio after spending weeks in the deep freeze and everybody brings out the bikinis and the lawn chairs and all that stuff, because that's just exactly how that happens after it's been so cold for so long and you get a slight warm up, then we start to feel a lot better. And then you add the sunshine with that, which we'll get today, then it makes it feel good. 39 degrees so far here in the city of Dayton. You'll notice the higher level clouds that are up there. Eventually, we're going to bring in a little bit more in the way of blue sky and sunshine. It's going to take a couple of hours or so. Look just to our south. There's a rainmaker down into Kentucky and moving towards the Appalachian chain. But the northern periphery of that maybe could make it into the southern portions of the Miami Valley, maybe towards the Cincinnati area. But you'll also notice this big patch of clearing that's just off to our west. So it's coming our way. We'll eventually roll the higher level clouds, get more blue sky and sunshine in here for the middle part of the afternoon. So far, winds coming in out of the east as this high pressure migrates eastward, and the winds are clockwise, so temperatures are in the 30s here across the Miami Valley so far. And we'll get some 40s as we go through the course of the afternoon. Looks like we're having a data problem here where some of my numbers aren't coming in fully as we're not getting the data from our weather information. But you can kind of make that out. 20-25 mile an hour wind gusts at times, so it is going to be on the breezy side this afternoon. Those temperatures are going to top out in the mid-40s, so it'll feel a little cooler, but at least we get some blue sky and sunshine. So I still think you'll need the coat and the hat just because of the breezes out there. It makes it feel a little cooler. I think the gloves are optional at this point in time. So we'll keep the breezes and the gusty winds out there at times up to about 25, maybe 30 miles an hour, make it feel a little cooler. Even in the evening time, if you're headed out, we got some pretty breezy to gusty winds overnight tonight. It stays pretty breezy tomorrow, too. The good thing tomorrow is that we're going to see temperatures about 10 degrees warmer in the mid-50s. So here's this afternoon. We get more sunshine in here. We'll cloud back up in the evening with a few showers around. So take the rain gear if you're headed out this evening. Overnight tonight and first part of the day tomorrow, we see more shower activity and we keep the clouds in there. And then by tomorrow afternoon, we break the clouds up and we reveal a little bit more sunshine. So we'll call it partly to mostly cloudy tomorrow afternoon. Then tomorrow night, overnight, Saturday night and Sunday, more showers, and then it's a wet one on Sunday with on and off again scattered shower activity. So 47 today, partly cloudy. The sun's coming in about next hour, hour and a half or so. At least we're in the 40s, though. And then overnight tonight, not as cold. 39 with scattered showers. It'll be wet first thing in the morning, and then we'll dry off for the afternoon tomorrow, partly to mostly cloudy. It'll be cloudy with on and off again showers, but breezy and warm, around 60 degrees for us on Sunday. Letitia's going to like that one. But then not going to like Monday and Tuesday, as it's a little shock to the system. But again, we're still above average with 46 and 44 for Monday and Tuesday. And we bring out the sunshine, temperatures in the 30s and 40s overnight over the weekend. Back into the 20s overnight next week, but at least those are not our daytime highs. And I'll get a lot of sleep with this clouds and sunshine because I'm going to be joining you first thing in the morning on Monday on Daybreak. And we need all the sleep I can get this weekend. You can help encourage me. Follow me on my social media pages and give me some bouts of encouragement there over the weekend, Letitia.
Welcome to the morning. Thank you, Dante. Well, it's the latest problem for